Hi, friends. Hello. It has come to my attention that you love to play games. So guess what? We're going to play another game. I know you've played this game before, but it also has come to my attention that you might need a review. And sometimes the second time, more people get answers correctly. So stay tuned for the How to Read Music game because you can never have enough review. Thank you for watching and good luck on the game. Are you ready to have fun today? It's How to Read Music Game. It's so much. We're going to play a game and we will have two teams. The team that answers the most questions correctly will win. So whoever is guiding this slideshow needs to divide the class in half. And if you're at home, you can play with a friend or you can play against yourself and see how many questions you get correctly. The team that has the most will win. Are you ready? Here we go. The first series of questions will be on symbol identification. Question 1. Name this symbol. Remember to raise your hand if your team knows it. The team should also take turns. If you said treble clef, you are correct. Way to go. Question 2. Name this symbol. You said staff. That is awesome. Moving right along. Question 3. Name this symbol. If you said quarter note, you are correct. Question 4. What is the name of this symbol? Remember, whichever team is going to raise your hand. If you said time signature, way to go. Question 5. Name this note. If you said half note, fantastic. Question 6. Name this note. You've got this. I know you can do it. If you said whole note, congratulations.
Question 7. Name this symbol. If you said quarter rest, good job. You guys are rocking it. All right, next question. How many beats per measure are in the following time signature? Looking for the number of beats per measure. If you said 4, you're a rock star. See that? You get extra. Question 9. What is the name of the symbol that divides the staff into measures? Remember to raise your hand or think in your head. Don't yell out. If you said bar line, you're a rock star. Moving right along. Question 10. What is the name of the symbol at the end of a song or exercise? Think. Look where the arrow is pointing. Answer, the double bar line. Woo, you guys are rocking it. The next series of questions will involve note names on the staff. Here we go. Please raise your hand if you can name the note at number 1. What is the note name for the bottom line of the staff? If you said E, you are correct. And you see we have our treble clef there. What is the name of the note on line 2? What is the name of the note on line 2? If you said G, awesome! What is the note name for 3, which is on space 2? What note name is space 2? Don't forget to raise your hand or think it in your mind. Make sure you're tallying all your correct answers if you're playing at home. If you said A, you're a rock star. What is the note name for number 4, which is the top space, which happens to be space 4? What is the letter name for the note on space 4? Don't forget to raise your hand. if you said E, awesome. Let's go to 5. What is the name of the note on space 3, which is the number 5 note? What is the name of the note on space number 3? Look at number 5. Think, people, think. You've got this. Space note 3. And if you said C, congratulations. And our last note, what is the name of the space note on space 1? Number 6, what is the name of the note on space 1? You can do it. Space 1. We count from bottom to top. And if you said F, you are fantastic. Way to go. You will find many symbols, obviously. All music symbols have a specific meaning to what you do with the music you are reading. For example, if a composer wants the song to have a section in the music that repeats, they will insert a repeat sign. This symbol tells musicians that they need to repeat a certain section of the music, or in some cases, the whole song. Here is a repeat sign, and that is the symbol you see in front of you. It is 2 dots on each end, and they circle the third line. They're right in the middle. So 2 dots flanking each side of the third line. So here's your question, final question. Remember to raise your hand. What does the repeat sign in music tell us to do? Don't forget to raise your hand. And of course, if you said, repeat, you paid attention. Way to go. You're awesome. As you can see, the repeat sign begins and ends right where you see the arrows pointing. One final question. In this example, how many measures would we repeat? Don't forget the bar line divides the staff into measures. So you are only looking for the measure, how many measures between the two repeat signs. If you know it, remember, raise your hand. How many measures would we repeat in this example? You can do it. You are a rock star. For the work you did today, you rocked it. Way to go. You're awesome. Great job. You have rocked this game. And we will see you next time. Have a great day.